We're free from the devil and free from your God. Stuck here in limbo, forever forgot. And we may look young, but our souls still are old. Tired of the stories and books we both wrote about. On and on. Angels will forever sing this song.
She sleeps too much. I was never that bad. He came into the room.
Sometime.
Sat down on the bed beside her.
Not usually.
What did he do to wake her up?
He'd sing a song.
Your father says he was your babysitter.
He was Annabelle's babysitter.
He was my friend. You looked up to him.
I guess so.
Like a brother.
No, we were friends. We liked to hang out.
You liked to skip school.
Who told you that?
The officer put out a report when he caught you at the mall.
I talked him into it. Reggie had never been in any kind of trouble before.
Yes, he kept it himself.
He's really quiet. A lot of people don't even know who he is.
Do you think that is why he spent so much time with you?
What?
Because he had so few friends.
Is that what my mother said?
You were a freshman at that time and he was a senior. It is a bit unusual.
He's only a couple years older.
4 and a half. Which is a long time when you're a kid. Family moved to your new home in the country, you haven't been able to sleep. Is that correct?
I can't sleep at night, except for maybe a couple hours. I just eventually pass out. I'd rather stay up and watch TV, but Mom won't let me. Put that in your report and tell your assistant to type it in all caps.
But you can't sleep with either.
I lie there.
You never get up.
Mother has a rule. Once you go to bed, you stay there until the sun comes up.
But you don't always follow that rule, do you?
Well, last Thursday...
Thursday wasn't the first time. Earlier, on March 10th, your mother discovered you in the upstairs of the house.
With Reggie.
Tell me about that.
I snuck to the bathroom for a glass of water, and I noticed there was a light on in the kitchen.
What time was it?
After 1.
Quite late.
When Reggie can't sleep, he stays up in the kitchen and studies star charts.
He likes stars.
He's taking astronomy at the university.
And he was up late that night studying.
He told me about supernovas. And gave me a nice shoulder massage.
Is he good? Does he often give you massages?
Sometimes, not often.
Why do you think he gave you one on this particular night?
Because I wasn't sleeping.
What happened after the massage?
He said it was a clear night and asked if I wanted to look through his telescope. I said
about going upstairs with Reggie, right?
No.
She told me that going upstairs was strictly forbidden. And your father mentioned an accident.
Annabelle cut her hand on some broken glass. It was her fault, goofing around.
So you have been told not to go up there.
Annabelle's the one who got hurt, and they tell me not to go.
And you go anyway.
I go up there all the time.
With Reggie?
Yes.
At night?
No. Daytime, when Mom's at work and Dad goes to buy supplies, I help him. I hand him tools when he needs them.
But on March 10th, you went up there to look at stars.
There's a balcony outside one of the windows. You can almost see the whole sky.
Were you happy to be there with Reggie?
Yes.
Did you feel you were doing anything wrong?
No.
And did Reggie do anything that made you uncomfortable?
No.
Did he touch you?
No.
It's okay to tell me, Evelyn.
I answered your question.
What were you wearing that night? Do you remember?
A nightgown, white with little yellow flowers.
Anything else?
Let me see my mother's report.
I can't.
I'm not answering any more questions unless I can see it.
Evelyn.
Show it to me right now or I'm leaving.
I'm sorry, but I can't.
She told you. She told my grandma too. Can you believe it? Like I'm the first person in the world who hasn't liked to wear underwear. Last year, she caught me going to school without my panties. I'll never hear the end of it.
And you weren't wearing underpants on the night of March 10th.
No, I can't stand them at night, especially when it starts getting warmer.
Did Reggie know that?
I don't know.
Did he ever say anything to you about it?
No.
You already talked about it with your mother.
She's the only one who yelled at me, if that's what you mean.
So your father approved of you going in public without wearing underwear?
He probably laughed. That's what he does when Mom tells him to put a shirt on.
He often appears without his shirt.
In the summertime when he's working?
Does Reggie take his shirt off when he's working?
Sometimes.
Did he take his shirt off at any point on the night of March 10th?
No.
And after he carried you upstairs, he was still wearing his shirt?
Yes. And his pants, too. He did take off his sweatshirt. I was cold. He let me wear it.
What else did he do?
He showed me the constellation.
Did you find Orion?
I never can. Reggie found him, and then he sang to me.
The singing of your mother.
She told me to go back to bed, but I could still hear her yelling at Reggie. And then Dad came home from work, and they yelled at each other.
But she didn't yell at you?
No. But the next day, Dad drove Reggie back to the city.
You've been seeing him for a while.
He was gone for about 2 weeks. And then Dad started driving him in on his days off. Said he needed Reggie's help. But Mom would only let him spend the night when Dad wasn't working much.
You never spoke to your mother about the events of March 10th?
No.
You were afraid she'd be angry?
Probably.
And you were not ashamed?
No.
You knew you had to obey her.
What else is new?
You were afraid she'd punish you.
I didn't do anything wrong.
But your mother thinks you did.
And Reggie knows I did.
So you respect Reggie's opinion more than your mother's?
Yes. He was there.
And until your mother came, you didn't think there was anything wrong.
I still don't.
You didn't feel strange when he carried you upstairs?
No.
You were safe.
I always feel safe with Reggie.
Midnight. You were worried. he hadn't come back.
I guess so. I mean, it wasn't like him to take off like that.
Your father told me that when Reggie spent the night at your house, you two would spend most evenings together.
We sit on the porch and talk and stuff. He studies, I read.
And that's what you do most nights?
Well, Mom won't let me go anyplace, so there's nothing else to do.
Is Reggie happy with that? Just hanging around?
It's not so bad. We have fun.
Your mother thinks it's odd, a boy his age and a girl as young as you.
My mother doesn't know me as well as Reggie. Reggie knows that I'm mature for my age.
Girls do mature more quickly than boys.
That's right.
When I was 18, I dated a law student.
Really?
27. So old. But I was mature too.
Was your mom pissed?
Of course. And of course I thought she was horribly old-fashioned and assumed that she just didn't trust me, you know? But I realized later that the one she didn't trust was me. I mean, why is this good-looking, eligible law student going after some 18-year-old freshman? You have to wonder what's wrong with this guy.
What did they say?
Who?
He's just quiet and a little awkward. The problem is, people don't listen to him. They don't talk to him. They think they understand without even asking the first question. My father says, oh, he's a good worker, as if that's all he's ever going to be. But that's just because they haven't taken the time to see.
But he's 19, and he spends every night hanging out on the porch with a 14-year-old kid.
There are plenty of older guys going out with girls in my class.
You two are going out.
I knew you'd twist my words.
I did not twist them, Evelyn. I repeated them. I must say, though, until now, no one has identified you and Reggie as a couple.
Yes, I didn't mean...
More like a brother and sister. So, you two are not dating.
Reggie's not into that.
How about you?
I'm not allowed to date until I'm 16.
Another of your mother's rules.
Exactly.
You wish you could go on a date right now. With Reggie.
I don't know.
I think he's cute. With those glasses.
Yeah.
And you know he likes you. I mean, you don't look 14. You are quite attractive. Remember in February when you got that new dress for the Valentine's Day dance? Your mom and dad wouldn't let you leave the house.
Who told you that?
Reggie.
I didn't realize you talked.
He said he knew that night you weren't a kid anymore.
Really?
When was the first time he kissed you?
Did he tell you?
No,
I kissed him.
Yes.
Well, you're almost right. Actually, I kissed him. I got tired of waiting.
When did he kiss him?
On the night of March 10th.
You lied.
No.
I asked you.
You asked if I did anything wrong.
Why was Reggie embracing you that night, Evelyn?
You know why.
I know what your mother says.
He said he thought I was dying.
But you were not dying.
No.
Not even injured.
No.
No blood, no broken bones.
That's right.
Something made you cry out. Your father said he has never heard you cry out like that.
I never have.
Your mother says there's only one thing that would make the girl speak.
I want to say,
Evelyn.
I don't have to say anything if I don't want to.
If you want to see Reggie again, I need to hear. I need you to tell me all of it.
What if I tell you? And you still don't understand.
Try me. Come on, hon. It was warm outside and you couldn't sleep. So
I snuck out my window into the backyard.
You had been waiting for Reggie to come back for hours. You figured if he could go wandering about in the middle of the night, why couldn't you?
Sure.
So you decided to go find him.
I went into the field behind my house and I stood there, perfectly still.
You had a feeling he would find you there.
No.
After all, you two had been there before at night.
No.
And this time, maybe he would miss you.
No.
You had seen him looking at you ever since that time in February. You're not a kid anymore.
I just wanted to go for a walk.
What were you wearing?
A white 100% cotton nightgown. A nightgown and nothing else. Underneath, I was naked. And though the night was warm, the breeze was enough to make my nipples hard. You got that, Miss Assistant?
Interesting outfit for a walk. You're not even wearing shoes.
I wanted to count the stars, but it was too cloudy.
So instead,
I listened.
What were you listening for?
Anything. But there was only silence. Even the crickets were sleeping. How would you like that, Miss Assistant, if you were listening and listening and listening, but there was nothing to hear?
You do not need to raise your voice.
Evelyn! You'll just have to remember the rest. There I was, standing in total silence and total dark, waiting.
What were you waiting for?
I didn't know, but I knew I couldn't move.
Why not?
I had been warned not to leave.
Evelyn, this is not a game.
Just listen, you'll remember.
Who warned you?
Have you ever been in a tornado?
No.
I was once at Grandma's house in Missouri. Right before it comes, it's very calm and quiet.
Evelyn, please. Who warned you?
Was it Reggie? I'm telling you. I was warned by the calmness of the night. A calm so calm, I knew something was not been right.
Tell me, what happened?
I felt that the silence, the darkness was there for a reason. That I was there for a reason. I was bound to the night.
How did your nightgown get wet?
The dew.
You lay down.
No. I took my nightgown off. Let it fall by.
Was Reggie there?
I was alone.
Tell me the truth.
I've never been so alone. I took my nightgown off so the darkness could surround me completely. I wanted there to be no separation.
But something happened. You were interrupted.
Yes.
Did you see your face?
It was the wind. Once I was naked, I felt it washing over me, separating me from the night. I knew then I could never be part of the stillness.
Because you're not still.
Yes. Yes, I could feel myself interrupting with my own breathing.
Were you sad?
No. It's the happiest I've ever been. I realized I could feel the silence and cover the darkness with light.
So you...
I closed my eyes.
Oh.
Took a deep breath.
Evelyn.
Let my mouth fall open.
There's no need to.
You know what happened then.
Yes.
I know what you think.
The pieces are there.
Reggie would never hurt me.
He already has, dear.
Oh?
Evelyn, you need to...
You know it hurts me.
I didn't say that.
You have discovered all my secrets.
No mortal could.
And soon you'll tell the world.
Evelyn!
Get your name in the paper.
No! Reginald is legally an adult, and you, Evelyn, are legally a child.
Don't.
He's your friend, and he took advantage of that.
You're wrong.
There are natural things and unnatural ones, Evelyn, and your very words suggest that Reggie has caused you to confuse the two.
You're wrong.
I wish I could believe that.
Why don't you?
Your words!
Oh, please.
You have created doubt.
You craved it.
Listen!
You took my words, and you made them into what you wanted them to be. You twisted and turned things that you couldn't understand.
I'm trying to...
Things you forgot long ago. And then, you made my words fit into what you already believe.
I asked questions.
And when I didn't have the answers?
Everything I have done was intended to.
Yes.
I am here. I am paid to... Evelyn, I realize it's difficult.
You can't even say it. You can't even put into words what I did, can you?
Maybe you should take a break.
No.
Have some lunch, maybe.
I'm not hungry.
Annabelle's in the waiting room.
What happens if I don't confess? Do you get in trouble or something?
No one's asking me to.
My dad used to sell washing machines and stuff at the store. But one month he then
trying to punish me.
Punish you?
If you would prefer to speak with someone else.
Why would I want to punish you?
I'm trying to make this as easy for you as possible.
Make it easy? To put Reggie in jail?
It might be the best thing.
You don't even know him.
I think I know him. We both want what's best for him.
I want him to come home.
From what you told me.
From what I told you? He should be able to come home by now. From what I've told you, you should realize this is no big deal. You have a big deal out of nothing.
As this case goes forward,
okay,
you will discover that many people disagree with you, Evelyn.
Yeah, well, I was there, an eyewitness, you know.
No one has questioned what you witnessed, only how you interpret it.
I see.
It's the middle of the night.
Yes.
And you're naked. A young woman naked in a field in the middle of the night, and a young man is there with her. In the past, she has kissed this young man, and he has held her in his arms. Now she suddenly begins to scream.
No.
These facts are part of the record, Evelyn. They're indisputable.
You're wrong.
Witnesses agree.
I disagree.
I have had just about enough.
I screamed, and Reggie came running.
And when your mother and father arrived shortly thereafter, there you were.
Yes.
Still naked.
That's true.
And you were not ashamed.
No.
Why not? Most girls your age.
You don't get it.
But you're not like most girls, right?
You're different.
Is that what he tells you?
Mature.
And what you and he have is special. He tells you that it will last forever. March 10th, he took you in his arms and spirited you away.
That's it.
And you had a special time together.
Sparkies.
Last Thursday was a special occasion too, huh? Evelyn, I think you should tell me exactly what happened. We know the basic details already, so your withholding evidence will do no one any good.
You think I'm no good.
I didn't say that.
But that's what it comes down to, right?
You tell me.
You think you've got it all figured out, but you're wrong.
Tell me.
I was alone. In the dark, in the wind. And then Reggie was there. I asked him to hold me, so he did. Enveloped me in those long arms. We kissed a little. But then he broke away. He sat there, silent, trying not to look at me. So I asked him to sing, and he did. And I danced around him up to the top of the hill. He was looking at me then, so I took my nightgown off. When he looked at me then, it was like he didn't know me. And he started to run back towards the woods. So I screamed. I screamed until he came and held me. Held me like he had when I was cold or scared. Not at all the way I wanted to be held. And maybe not the way he wanted to hold me.
What did he want?
Don't you see? It's not about what he wanted. It's about what he did. He held me. Let me cry into his shirt. He begged me to put my nightgown back on. He kept saying, Evelyn, it's not right. You think that night in the field with Reggie was the first night I was a woman. But you're wrong. That was the last night I was a little girl.